normally when an eagle flies, he goes up to an altitude where the wind gets up beneath his wings, and he just soars. And he stands there and floats and soars for and watch down for his prey. When he spot his prey, he lock his eyes on it, put his wings back, and he dives.
He descends, huh?
Till he get in striking distance, then that's when he throw the brakes on, the air brakes on, and throw them talons out.
Throw the air brakes on, huh?
Scoop him up and hit them wings, and they accelerate back up into the air with him.
Golden Rider, a shadowy flight into the dangerous world of a man who is fearless. A young loner on a crusade to champion the cause in a world of reckless automobiles. These are my motovlogs.
Anything behind you there, Charles?
That truck's still behind me.
Okay. But once we get in front of this,
Once he cleared that truck that we just passed, it's all cleared going on down.
Well, I'm going to wait a little bit because we still got these old trucks in the right lane.
Yeah. That's
well, you want to get on past them.
Yeah.
First chance you get.
Exactly.
Because they go hog up the lanes and slow down and speed up climbing hills.
Yeah.
Sure is. Man got a full camper on the back of his.
Yeah.
Full camper.
That's an old remodel.
Got the Jeep pulling that thing. Yeah, I had a good time hanging out with Buster today.
Yeah, Buster ain't coming on.
Buster's something else.
Yeah, yo, Buster, he went up to Virginia with us.
Buster and Calvin.
Yeah, Buster and Calvin. That was his wife taking those pictures.
Uh-huh.
I'm still a little full from that barbecue, though.
Yeah, that sandwich was nice, man.
Martin's barbecue joint? Real good. Look like we're hitting a little dry pavement.
Yeah.
I flipped my shield up and raised my head up so it could blow the raindrops off and give me a clear shield.
Yeah.
Look at that buzzard out there on the side of the road.
Yeah.
Getting that roadkill.
The old buzzard. So, Charles, this is the second time you've had to put your rain suit on?
Yep.
Well, at least it cooled it off because it was hot, man. It was smoking hot.
Well, it was storming hot.
Man, what?
Man, it cooled us off quick, too.
Yeah, it was almost, seemed like it was almost 100 degrees.
Yeah. My bike was reading 95. Yours was reading 95.
Oh, okay. How is everybody looking on fuel?
I'm a bar over.
I'm at the first notch. How are you, Charles?
I'm a little past four. I mean a little past half.
Okay.
A couple notches past half.
Yeah, me too. Yeah. What about you, Godspeed?
I'm one notch down.
From half.
I'm one notch down from four.
Okay. Oh, okay. Man, you must have got an extended tank on that thing. he might have in that big old trailer, man, he might have an extra fuel tank in his saddlebag or something, man.
Got it hooked up, huh?
Flatbed rolling, man.
Yeah, it is. God almighty, you got to be. We doing good.
Yeah, he rolling.
Yeah.
Pass him.
Y'all trailer's looking good, guys.
Thank you, Charles. Thank you, my brother.
Looking good. It might have stable.
Thank you, Charles.
Sir.
I'm gonna go to this right lane once y'all clear this truck. Let me know when y'all clear this flatbed.
Okay.
When you clear it, Charles, I'm gonna take this right lane.
I got you.
I mean, we could stay over here, but it's still a truck behind you.
He's a little ways back.
Charles is at the end of the trailer, and he's getting ready to. He just cleared.
Okay, I'm going to this right lane. Going to the right lane.
Looks like sunshine in front of us. Sunshine.
Blue skies. Please don't go away.
My girl has found another and is gone away.
With her went my future. My life is filled with gloom. So day after day, I stay locked up in my room. I know to you, it might sound strange, but I wish it would rain.
Oh, I wish that it would rain.
Yeah. Cause so badly, I wanna go outside.
Such a lovely day.
But everyone knows that a man ain't supposed to cry. Listen, I gotta cry, cause crying eases the pain, oh yeah. People, this hurt I feel inside, words could never explain. I just wish it would rain.
Oh, I wish that it
let it rain. Rain.
Oh, I wish that it would rain.
Let it rain.
Let it rain.
Oh, yeah. Let it rain.
Is that the new Supra?
It looked like one.
It looked like a Zion, a little Toyota Zion.
Oh, okay.
Uh-huh. Had a Toyota emblem on it. It didn't have the Zion emblem.
Oh, I thought the Zion was in the back.
Had they went under the same badge yet?
I'm going to this left lane. Okay. I'm going to go to this left. Coming into a curve. I see him. That's why I'm going to the left. In his curve. Did he get in front of you, Charles?
Oh, he beside me, right beside me.
Okay.
Come on, Randy, get in front. Charles, come on, Randy, get in between us.
He won't let me over.
Yeah, come on, Randy, get in between us. Hey, Charles, look back now. When they see that big ass trailer, it changes the game. They treat me like a cop.
I know that.
You ain't lying.
He was all up on Charles when he was out back there. But soon as he came in the middle and I took the back, she backed up.
Yeah, the faster you go, the faster you go, the faster they go.
Yeah.
They need to
cut this. I ain't want to really turn it on it. I ain't really want to, you know.
Yeah, don't open it up on the Charles.
Yeah, I ain't going to open it up. I ain't going to twist the throttle.
Don't make the flame shoot out that tailpipe.
I ain't going to do it to him. I ain't going to open the six up on him.
They need to cut this grass out here on 40.
Sure do.
Yeah, they need to cut this grass, man.
They trying to save them tax dollars. But guess what? How you saving tax dollars when you got people on the payroll to do that?
Yeah, I know.
Man.
That part right there.
Cut the grass.
Can anybody explain to me how you saving money when you got people on the payroll that get paid to do it?
I don't know. Let me know when you get it figured out.
Hey, the only thing I can figure is paying them is one thing. Burning the fuel and using the equipment, maybe they counting the cost of that and saying they saving something.
Well, you know what? Grass don't stop growing, so you're going to have to cut it.
So
yeah, it ain't going to stop.
But it makes the job a heck of a lot harder.
Yep.
On a bush hog, anything else, when you let it overgrow.
Yeah. I think we're coming up on this. What is this highway? Is it 440, 880 or something?
Look like 840.
840?
Like GPS saying 840.
Yeah, that's right, 840. It's a new highway they cut in. I forgot the number on it, but.
That's the new highway that they finally finished. Took them about 10 years to do it right before the Tennessee River.
Get a little airflow going.
That's how I keep up with it. You when you get here, going back, you go through them S curves and then you cross over the Tennessee River.
Man, I hate I didn't get a chance to say.
Look
go
over
ahead.
To the right, boy. Look at that rain over there.
To the right?
Yeah, that's rain. Them look like cloud. That's rain.
I don't know.
What'd you say? I'm sorry, Chris. What'd you say?
It looked like clouds, but it could be rain.
Yeah, that's rain right there.
Okay.
Big downfall.
So mist coming off this truck.
What'd you get ready to say, Chris, for that?
I was just saying it's mist coming off this truck, messing with my eyesight. Getting a straight line. I'm going to pass him. Righty, let's get past this guy.
Gotcha.
spray. He kicking up.
Yeah,
kicking it up, boy.
Yeah, messing with your eyes, cause it. We rolling. I'm gonna go to this right lane.
Okay. Straight guy's feet.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
I hate we didn't get a chance to say bye to Buster.
Oh,
and
yeah,
Calvin, yeah.
Yeah, Buster got the getting in
it. Yeah. Godspeed said they was over under the bridge when we went by.
Yep, they were sitting under the bridge.
I didn't see them. Did you see them? Did you see them, Charles?
I seen something. I didn't know that was them.
Oh, okay. I didn't even see them. I probably was too busy watching my
phone. Yeah, you know, that was a tri-bridge, so they was up at the top at the second layer, up under that bridge. That car came, that black vehicle that came across the three lanes?
Yeah.
Across the front of your bike? When it went up that ramp, it went up there, and that's how I got to see them, because I was looking at it. They was off the bikes and standing up there.
Yeah, I seen them. I didn't know that was them, though.
I locked his cruise.
He didn't know what he was doing. Is that the same little Chevy that was getting you?
I think it is.
Yep, it is.
Dodo head.
Same
Chevy. Is that same one? I see her driving.
Yep.
Man, that's pitiful.
I'm going to go to this right lane.
Okay.
Gotcha.
We got a truck
on the right side?
We got a truck up here on the right lane. Let's see.
Okay.
We'll just hug the left side of the road. We'll be all right.
Yeah.
Piece of the time.
Carry that railroad load. I hate to carry those. It's money, but it's hard on your truck because them trailers heavy.
It is. Look like we're hitting a few clear skies. They got some clouds in front of us, but it looks better in front of us than it does behind us.
Sure does. Well, we done got a little bit in front of it. Now.
I'm going to take this left lane.
All right.
Because it's kind of curving to the left here. Uh-oh. Slow it down a little bit. Yeah, we getting a lot of pocket showers.
That was a little puddle cross there. That,
yeah.
Yeah, pocket showers, man.
Yeah.
Let's slow it down a little bit. Now, Charles, you don't have a vent on your bike, right? You just let the windshield up and down?
Yeah, I don't have no vent. Uh-huh.
Okay. So what do you do to get air in? Is it you let the window up? I mean, let it down.
Let it down?
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Make it a shorty, huh?
Yep. Open my visor.
Well, one thing about it, if we get stranded, I know Godspeed got enough crystals, enough white castles to last us for 2 or 3 days.
That's a Corona just passed. See them fat trucks right there?
Uh-huh.
Those are Coronas. Those two trucks that just passed is going back the other way.
Uh-huh.
Like Coronas.
Corona, like the beer Corona?
Yeah, that's the name of them. Corunda.
Oh, I thought you meant like the virus.
Yeah. It sounds, all of it sounds the same. But they usually have a Series 60 motor in them. Pushing about 505 plus horses.
Oh, 500 horses on a truck.
You either get them with a 10 speed, a 13, or 18 speed.
Got some plastic coming in the road.
Okay.
Found a Fitzgerald glider kit. You never get rid of those trucks.
Yeah.
That's a truck you buy if you're gonna be a trucker for life.
You ain't lying.
How much them trucks run? God sake.
Huh?
How much they cost?
How much are they?
Yeah, how much are they?
Started about 160,000, and you can get them all the way down to about 45 or 50,000,
okay.
Depending on what year.
All right.
How much is the 1970 model? That's the one I want. I can afford that one. I can afford that one.
You can go get an 07. You can go get an 07. It is going to be $30,000-$40,000.
Give me one of my old Macs. Give me that old Mac, man, with the granny gear on it.
You got to remember. You got to remember in the trucking game, you got to have a truck that's the industry gonna recognize. If it ain't new, the only way they gonna recognize is if you got a glider kit. A glider kit means your engine been redone, transmission. Your rear end, the whole truck been totally redone, and it's ready to go another 100,000. And people that do those kind of trucks, they plan on keep running them.
Yeah, like
they run them, like make their money, stack it up, keep their maintenance up, and then they send it back to the shop to get redone again. They don't buy new trucks. That's the kind of trucking I like doing.
Yeah.
Right. Well, I couldn't even afford the fuel in it.
Yeah, you could.
Let alone the truck.
It'll pay for itself. What you do, you get one, and you run it, let it pay for itself. And after it pay for itself, you turn around and buy another one, and you take that old one that you know everything about, and you put your driver in it. It's a shortage of drivers. That's why all these companies are giving you a sign-on bonus.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I see the old sign all the time that says, you know, sign on bonus. I think a lot of everybody doing that kind of, you know, doing deals like that with them sign on bonuses.
Well, the thing is, most of these young folks, they worry about having a good time. They don't know how much money you can make.
Yeah.
Getting in a truck, get through that first year. Until you then build your time in where you can get a dedicated run.
Right. Yep.
It take you a little while to build up a clientele like that, though.
Huh?
It take a little while to build up a clientele like that, right?
Yeah. I mean, I'm trying to get all my sons in it.
Yeah.
My oldest son in it. My youngest son is 19, another one is 21. If I can get them, I know my baby boy gonna do it.
Yeah. It's a bunch of money in it, man. Bunch of money.
Ooh. If you can get your young man into it while they're young, before they get a whole bunch of bills, and let them get their money stacked up, where they can have their own truck and go get out there, take care of their truck right. Show them how to do it, make their money, they be set for life.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
Got a new generation, though. You know, they don't understand sacrifice and work.
By the time they 25, 26, they should be there if they listen and do what they're supposed to do, stay out them streets, they have enough money to build their own house from the ground up.
Yeah.
Yeah.